Every year, the National Press Club in Washington holds an annual book fair that features dozens of authors. Book TV attended the fair this year and spoke with several nonfiction authors, including retired Marine Corps Lieutenant Colonel Kate Germano and Army veteran Kelly Kennedy, who offered their thoughts on gender bias in the military.
Kate Germano is retired Lieutenant Colonel of the Marines, and Kelly Kennedy, her co-author, is an Army veteran. They're the authors of Fight Like a Girl, The Truth Behind How Female Marines Are Trained. Kate, tell me what happened to you in 2016.
It was a very abrupt ending to my command tour after being at Parris Island in charge of the only all-female unit in the entire Department of Defense. I was in charge of training all of the female Marines for the Marine Corps in their enlisted boot camp. And we were making historic progress to improve their performance. And because of the fact that we were holding them to higher standards, the recruits and the drill instructors, my bosses established that I had been mean and too hard on them, and so I was fired from command.
Now, you had a 20-year career in the military. Tell us about how you were placed in leadership.
So command in the Marine Corps is a big honor, and you are actually screened by a group of very senior officers, and you're selected, you're hand selected for the position. And being selected for command of 4th Battalion was extremely important because it is the only place where we make female Marines.
Kelly, you've reported for the Army Times and USA Today on vet issues and health policy. How are women trained differently than men in the military?
It's only the Marine Corps, so the other services, the women and the men train together. But in the Marine Corps, they train them separately, and they tell women things like your arms are too short to be able to shoot well. I'm not sure what they tell the short male Marines, but the women are told they just can't train the same way. So it's a problem, I think. I think that if you're in the Marine Corps and you're supposed to be like this, if you're training with the Marine Corps and you're supposed to be the most elite branch, why are the men and the women trained separately when the Army is saying, hey, yeah, you can be in the infantry and you can train with the men and you can shoot as well and you can run as fast, but the Marine Corps is saying you're the most elite but not able to, right?
And Kate, what were you doing that the Marines had an issue with in regards to your leadership and the training that you were giving your cadets?
Sure. I believed in holding my Marines accountable for confidence, accountability, and pride. And so one of the things that was very important for me was for them to make sure that they were holding their recruits accountable for high standards and high performance. And so the natural assumption by the male Marines in the leadership was that there was no way the female recruits could perform and achieve what they were achieving unless I was being too hard on them. So it was a real eye-opening case of gender bias in that we treated the male Marines and the male recruits very differently than we treated the female recruits and Marines.
People listening to this may find that counterintuitive. They think of Parris Island as being one of the toughest places to go, and they're telling you that you were being too tough?
Right. And they were saying I was being too tough for holding Marines and recruits accountable for meeting high standards. So when you think about our national defense, my thinking is I want all of my Marines, regardless of gender, to be able to be fast, strong, and good shots on the rifle range. And so the idea that I was too hard on them because they were women really flew in the face of what we think of when we think of Marines.
Kelly and Kate, you write about a $35 million integration study that was done by the United States Marine Corps to defend their position. Can you touch upon that?
So I had the distinct privilege of being in command of the 4th Battalion right as the Marine Corps was putting this case study together, using that study as the foundation to basically demonstrate that women were not physically and mentally tough enough to go into the infantry. And so what we were achieving at Parris Island, the historic results we were achieving, really flew in the face of that study and conflicted with the narrative that the Commandant wanted to achieve. So it was really easy to get rid of me and perpetuate this cycle of bias against women in order to prove that women couldn't be tough enough to go into these new jobs like the infantry.
No. I think that in the book we make the case that Kate was fired because the Marine Corps didn't want women in the infantry.
Now,
still the case.
Now, the leadership will point to the fact that for the Marines that they shouldn't be integrated with men and women. But as far as the troops on the ground, what are their feelings?
It's really interesting. Since I was fired, over the last 2 years, the Marine Corps has actually made great strides in integrating training. They'll never say it was because of the work that I did, but they are in the process of doing that. So that's interesting. But the reality is that young men and women, they have grown up playing sports because of Title X. The students in high school are seeing women excel in leadership positions. So for them, the expectation that women can't compete with their male counterparts is a surprise. And so I think that what we're going to see is they're going to demand change, and they're going to see the Marine Corps evolve in ways that I wasn't able to accomplish.
Kate Germano, you taped an afterwards program with us in May of 2018. If you're watching this, you can go to our website and take a look at that. What do you do now?
So I actually am in school at Georgetown for diversity and inclusion, and I've just started my own consulting work.
Kate Germano, she's a retired Lieutenant Colonel of the Marine Corps. Kelly Kennedy, she's an Army veteran, and she's done reporting for Army Times and USA Today. Their book, Fight Like a Girl, The Truth Behind How Female Marines Are Trained, it came out this spring by Prometheus Books. Thanks so much.
Appreciate it.
Keep an eye out for more interviews from the National Press Club's book fair to air in the near future. You can also watch them and any of our programs in their entirety at booktv.org. Type the author's name in the search bar at the top of the page.